Good morning.
This is to introduce you to the Gympa Business School Practitioners Forum course. I'm Dr. Yorson, and I'll be taking you through the course. The course covers four programs for all the four academic years. So we'll be doing it till the level 400. You have a foundation. The program is that you have a foundation, you have your first principles, that's level 200, and then you're doing your strengthening business knowledge at level 100, and then you are doing integrating and applying concepts. This is generally the program that you have. And each student will have to complete a number of courses in the program, and the only exceptional courses that have been added to it is the Practitioners Forum and the Entrepreneurship of the Self, the career planning, which are located 1 hour credit hours. The Practitioners Forum course has been added to this program to add in-depth knowledge in business concepts and to emphasize Practitioners Forum and the knowledge of practices delivered through the Practitioners Forum. So you're going to have a series of presentations and interactions from seasoned industry players. What you're going to do is that the course will be delivered through the Gympa Management Learning System, and you'll be required to get your email address, the school email address. I don't want any Gmails, I don't want any Hotmail addresses in there. It is not proper to do that. And you'll be delivered in 8 courses. So level 100, you'll have Practitioners Forum 1 and Practitioners Forum 2. Level 200, you have 3 and 4. 300, you have 5 and 6. And then 400, you have 7 and 8. That's what you're going to have. So these are the teams that you're going to look at. You'll be looking at Practitioners Forum 1, coping with 21st century education. And then the presentations is to emphasize some of these things. Then Practitioners Forum 2, that's the second term, you're going to do career identification and prospecting. And then the team will help you. We have some presentations just like we're going to have today. And then a review of that. And you write your exams there. The Practitioners Forum 3, you're looking at professional roles and their development. And Practitioners Forum 1, Forum 4, you're looking at personal development. Practitioners Forum 5, you're looking at entrepreneurship, but you're looking at identification and prospecting. And Practitioners Forum 6, you're looking at entrepreneurship, getting involved. That is, you are getting involved, how to get involved, how to understand. Because most of the time, you're looking at entrepreneurship, and the whole thing is that people think that entrepreneurship means you're going to start your own business. No, we have to understand what is entrepreneurship, getting the mindset itself. It's a mindset, it's a behavior, it's a habit that you have to get into to be able to daily go about your duties to be successful in the industry. So you need that mindset even when you are working for somebody. When you go into an entrepreneurship environment and you don't have that mindset, you're only going to have problems with the person who is leading. Because the person will be thinking in a certain way and you can't catch up. Why is it forcing me? Why those are some of the issues that we have to do. Why should we come at this time every day? Why should we be punctual? That's one of the things that we have in this country. We take it for granted, that, but it's a mindset. It's a habit that people you follow to be successful. Then we have the Practitioners Forum 7, getting ready for the working world. That's basically what you have to do specifically, selecting industry-specific instruments, how they do your interviews, what is required. Nowadays, you go for interviews, there are a lot of you have to write an aptitude test. You go through all your 4 years in the university and you don't write any aptitude test. You go into the interview and you have to write an aptitude test. So how do you practice? How do you get yourself prepared to do that? What are the things that you have to be looking for? Those are some of the things that we have to be talking about. And then, Practitioners Forum 8, we're looking at the essentials of graduate employment. This is basically what is required. What are the graduate attributes? When somebody says you are a graduate, does he expect from you? Because if you're employed as a graduate, and you employ somebody with a diploma or a certificate or something, what are the expectations of that person, of the employer? For you, because sometimes they tell you, but you are a graduate, and it's like, where it's because a certain the attribute, skill set is required from a graduate, and that these are some of the things that we have to you have to know. So when you go to the workplace, you have to, yes, it's not about dressing. Yes, you have the formal dressing, all right, but you also have to deliver a certain amount, yes, of work, a level of work that is at a certain level higher than others for you to be able to do. Yes, and then obviously the way you speak and all those things, the level of English that you speak, the words that you use, they are all graded. You go out there and you talk about accent. What are we? Yes, and you look at it. What are these? What do they expect? What do you expect? They measure your education by the way you do some of these things. Okay, and the mode of delivery, 6 sessions that you have. For those who have taken that one, they know level, practice from 1, this is what you have to do. And then the teaching approach, that's a big word, pedagogic approach, is through, you have to interact. It's a constructive, social constructivist thing. You have to interact, just like you're interacting on your the YouTube and other social media blogs. That is it. You look at it, you read it, you understand it, you have problems with it, there's a chat, there's a forum, you put your questions there, then other people who have different ideas will also put their questions there, and then I open it every morning to look at it, and if you have problems, I interact with you, I try and answer what are the concepts that this person is dealing with in the system, and then you can also, you have, the system has an email thing, so if you have any problem, you can send an email to me directly through the system, the info management system to me, and then I will give you a feedback on that. So the issue, the reasons as to, our class professor said this and this and that. Those things, they don't, nowadays, yes. It's irrelevant now. Yeah, because in the emails, you can have it, and then in the course outline, you have my phone number and all that, and those things. So those things become, if you come and then start using that as a reason for not doing well. I mean, those are some of the things. And then we will also going to look at, appreciate and reward the interactions on the system, how you interact. There are some people who just don't do anything. They don't even read the questions, and then they come up with a report, and a hard copy report, and put it there. But they don't even put the soft copy report into the system. So I will check all these things. And if you don't do that, you'll be penalized for that from now on. That is because you've not submitted your assignment. And we have to check, because we have to check with, we get a soft copy, we check against all the others for you to know whether somebody's copied your work or you've copied somebody's work and all that. And there's a software to do that. And that's why we are looking, we want you to give you a soft copy for us to look at it. And then we are doing it to all the other campuses as well. So we have to check, we have an idea of what you are submitting, and then we also look at that. So that's what Yes, the mode of assessment is the preparation of a reflective report, and it is based on all the 4 sessions, the 4 major practitioners' presentations that will be made. And from now on, you have six sessions, and you have 6 presentations, an intro and a review. But then the four from 2 to 5. That's where you look at it, and then you are there. But you have to watch everything to understand it, to help you to understand some of these things. And you do your practitioner's form. There may be, when you get to level 300 or 400, there may be other things that will be asked, assignments, like CV, application letter, personal statements, and those things. Maybe you'll be required to maybe write based on what the presenter wants you to do, so that we will look at some of these things. And the participant, so we've already talked about the interaction on the platform. It will be recognized, the chat and the surveys and all that. Those will be required. Because that is, most of the time, you have to be conversant with all these things. Because most of the time, if you're going to even look for work, for somebody, applications, now everything is online. The old way of trying to just write an application letter and then throw it in. You go to any multinational and you have to go to the page and even paste whatever you typed into the system, and then you work. So you don't meet the HR people. You just have to paste it in and they will come up. So you have to write good English and all that. That's important. Know WhatsApp English, please. Those are some of the things that are required to do that. And you participate in that. So in the participation, yes. When you are asking questions, you have to write good English, like proper in the passive. It's not like what you write on YouTube and those things. Okay. The report, the reflective report that a lot of people are having problems with or talking about, is that it finds a balance. You see, the report finds a balance between individual learners' writing skills, your writing skills, and also their critical thinking. Because whatever the person says, the industry person says, the facilitator says, you think about it and then relate it to yourself, your experience, before writing that experience. You are not reporting, you are not a reporter to be reporting just what the person says. Yes, that's what it was. I'm going to put all these things on your on the system, so you don't have to worry about it. Everything is going to be on the system. That's why we're recording. Yes, and then also the ability to grasp the practitioner's concepts and strategies. What is the person talking about? How does it relate to me in my career development plan? Those are some of the things that you have to pick up in the your ability to pick up those things. That is the things that. That's why the report is only limited to a two-page report. Okay. Yes, if you are just reporting everything, then we write a 5-10 page or 5-page or whatever things, and we then report everything that you say. But it's your experience basically that is required in there. We will talk about that. So the mode of that's what we know. The mode of assessment differs from the general mode of assessment for other courses. Other courses, they want group work and all. This is an individual report, and every report should be different. That is what is expected, because each person has a different experience. You may go to the same, you may be in the same class with a person, but you went to different schools, you are at different stages of your life and those things like that. So these are issues that will reflect in the report. So that's why we expect individuals to be. So you copy somebody's work and you are caught. That's because it's not the same thing like, yes, math, everybody should get, and the answer should be 22. So we are all, every we have to write 22 and send it to him. And when he sees 22, yes, 100, yes, no, that's not how this one works. It's slightly different. Okay. Yes. It's an example of it. You have examples on the system. Looking at reflective writing examples. Okay, and I realized that when you go into it, the system in such a way that you can check as to whether people are reading it or not. And most people don't, you see, never seen, they've not even read it. So if you don't look at examples in the system, how do you know how to write the report? It is not just any report. So somebody say, "Oh, and my roommate says we should do this," and we all wrote a report and we get it. No, but then everything is in the system. This is the only course that in the first day, you have all the lectures given to you. You have the course outline, you have the exams question, which is the reflective report question in the system, and you have the marking scheme in the system on day one. The moment the system is opened, you have all those things. So all you have to do, even if you don't understand it, read the marking scheme and say, hey, this is what is required, and then you go back to it and then know how do we study for this one to pass it. To be realistic, if you are looking at it and say, well, what is this man looking for? What are they looking for? You look at what is required and then go back and look at it and take it. It's not a one weekend thing. One day you wait till there's a deadline for us to submit the work, and then everybody then you write something. And there are some people, somebody wrote one paragraph and expect to pass. And even that paragraph was copied from somewhere. These are issues that means you are not learning. That's all that you go. So these are some of the examples of that. You have a lot of examples in there. Then you have, they're reflectively evaluating it, the depth of reflection, that your examples that you give, how is it relating to your personal experience? You just don't write that, oh, it was good, and we want, most of them, one line, you give me a one line conclusion. Oh, it was good, and we think we'll have it every day. Let us all have it, and then do it in everything. It's good for all the students. We are failing. That's the reality. How does it relate to your personal experience? Maybe because of what you've heard, like on the personal development, oh, because of that, I've decided that maybe I would enroll in the next year or something in a professional course. I'm trying to investigate the professional courses or institutions in my area of study to be able to enroll or to be able to know which subjects can I get exemptions from and those things like that. Then we know you are learning and thinking about what you heard. You heard it. It's not about it was good. Then you are, yes, it's not good. Yes, then the required components of the report. The report simply says that in the course assignment, and then that's why it is course assignment and guidelines. People read the assignment and read the guideline. But the guidelines will help you to understand it. The guideline tells you specifically that you have to get an introduction of it, and then a body and a conclusion. So if you write anything that doesn't have those things, then you know you are not getting any marks for that area. So all these areas carry marks, the required components of the report present. Then you have the structure of it. You have to be properly structured. The argument should be sort of thing. Yeah, you tend to have people writing one-line paragraphs, and I don't know whether they are listing it or not. It's not proper writing. It's not the right way to do it. Your idea, a paragraph should consist of an idea. You close up the idea nicely. It may be three or four paragraphs and lines, sentences. You discuss an idea or give an example. That is because it's not a big report. Yes, don't you close it. Then also evidence of the practice. That's what I said in the conclusion. The conclusion, yes, that area only also carries about 25% of the mark. And the other people just write one sentence. It was good. That is it. And if you write it was good, you've lost 25 marks. Yes, okay, yes. So, yes, this is what I highlighted this one, because exploring and reading and adhering to the information of the is more important than binding the report. But I saw binding the report doesn't give you any marks. I've told you over and over again. Yes, but is it just a two-page report? How do you bind a two-page report? Yes, if you want it to be nice, that's okay, etc. If you have it and you have anything, but then it's not a requirement for it. What I want you to do is adhere, read the material, adhere to the instructions that it's been, and then you bind it. Nothing that annoys me. than copying somebody's work and binding it. It adds more. It means that the person just, you copy somebody's work and you bind it nicely. What are you trying to do? Yes. Okay. Yes. Then there's this issue of this copying thing. Academic dishonesty is important. You look at your handbook. You have your students' handbook, yes. You turn to section 7.1 and 7.2. These are some of the things you have to, don't have to falsify or fabrication of data, like some things, lying and trying to do cheating, receiving, purchasing, selling of research. Yes, people go out there, they give them the assignment, they give it to somebody to write it for them, and they pay them and all that. These are but you see, the problem is that when you do some of these things, the skill set that is required to be developed in you, you don't get it. You part with money. Okay, but then the next time you are given the same assignment, you have to go and pay the money again. And you go to the workplace, and it means that then that consultant will be your workmate, basically. Because everything you are given a letter to write, you have to go and give it to him or her to print, and then go. So those things are part of it. In today's workplace, things like writing, most of the offices, they don't get a secretary. It's only you go to an office, it's only maybe the director or two who has a secretary. The rest, you are supposed to do your thing on your laptop and get it printed somewhere. So all these things are things that you are required to do. You should know. As a graduate, you are expected. If you are a graduate, you don't know Word, Excel, and those things. Then where you got your qualification is being called into question. That's how the world is now. Yes, no matter which subject, even if it's medicine or you are supposed to know some of these things. Okay, so cheating and then plagiarism, copying people's work and presenting it as yours, those are some things that is not required. So in the course outline, I've simplified it into this: allowing somebody to copy your work, copying somebody's work, impersonating students on the gamepad. Yes, I've seen one or two people, they've given Gmail addresses to people to go to their system so that they can help them to write the report and those sorts of things. And I know they are strange names. And then the use of non-gamepad email addresses, that is how the whole thing, they are trying to use. Because I expect you to have a gamepad, you use your gamepad email so that we can identify you on the system. That is it. Those are some of the things. And then any other thing it's not required as an academic person to do. Somebody actually did copy send the work to somebody, to the consultant to do for him, and he sent it back to him. And what he did, he also forwarded the work, including all the email communication, to me. Yes, yeah. I mean, he didn't even understand that you have to submit it into the system. He submitted it to me. I mean, yeah, I mean, some of these things, it's not done in an academic environment. You don't do that. Okay. So to give you a few recommendations, all the needed documents, as I've said, report are available on the system, all the thing. You just go in, read it. But that's why we give our 2 months to be looking at some of these things. Take 1 weekend, all you need to do, you are exploring it, click on it, the PDF will open or download, you look at it, you read it a little bit, you get 1 weekend just to get all the stuff, understand what the thing is, but another weekend. Then you decide that maybe you take 1 other weekend to study seriously to understand what it is. And then you can move on and jot down the points and write down your report. That is the thing. Because the system can generate reports on each individual. So sometimes you look at the report and you go into the system and you look at what the person has done in the system and you realize that the person has actually not read anything in the system and he's trying to write the report. That is why the person is failing. That one nobody can sympathize with you because you've not done anything. Each individual, the system generates a report on the files that you've looked at in the system. That's how the system, that's why it's the learning management system. So you know, yeah. So if the person is getting a D or a D plus, yeah, and then you check that one and say, what is happening? Why? And then you know some of this. It's not that there's some people in GEMPA who are trying to give students a lot of problems by failing them and those things. These are all parts of the thing that you have to do. Okay, detailed assignment guidelines, that is it. The evidence is that students don't, that's why we turn to, they don't read the material that is available in the system. They think it's a YouTube thing that you want to do it last minute. So 1 weekend, you can write everything. If you can do it 1 weekend, nobody will give you 2 months to do it. That's the thing. Nobody will give you 2 months to do something that you can just do it 1 day, right? We can then just write and give it to them. Yes, those are some of the things that you have to also think about. Yes. And then also a few things, household things. Yes, the people fail to use the report, the cover sheets that we put on the report. They don't get their names right. Somebody write Ya Baby and all that. But you know, in the school, you didn't actually register as Ya Baby. So if somebody is using your name to look for your, it becomes difficult and that sort of thing. And then you're getting your index number right is also important. Yes, those are some things. Yes, we all know it should be 9, but there are a few others. There are 8. There are those things, 8 digits and all that too. It means that something is missing. You have to be going around to look at that. And then, of course, the campus, the course, whether it's day, evening, you indicate on it. Okay, yes. And they fail to abide by the instructions, the formatting instructions. It should be 12 points. You can either choose New Times Roman and those. All the instructions are given there. And then somebody thinks that he's smart. And then that everything uppercase and increases it to 14 or 15 so that he can get all his things to fill in into 2 pages. But if you do that, you think you are doing smart, it's just 2 pages. But the problem is that it won't help you to get enough points into the report to get you the aid that you are looking for. Because you've just increased the size, so you are filling up the page. But you also know that you are just taking up enough space where you can put in points to give you the marks. And then you get telephone calls, say, why didn't I get an A? I said, but it's for your fault. Those are some things. Okay, then. All right. Yes, endeavor to read, which we have, I don't want to overemphasize it, and read the emails provided. You can send emails and also emails that are sent to you as to, yes, what is going on in the system and then the changes and all that you have to do. And then, yes, apply your knowledge and the theories and techniques to the presentations that has been made. Those are some of the things that I want you to look at. Okay, so this ends the introduction to the practitioner. What is this? So, any questions that you want to ask about the practitioners from course in general?
What I expect from the practitioners from course? Mm-hmm. I want to broaden my horizon of things outside the classroom. Maybe how it affects my life in the workplace or your personal business. That's what I want.
You won't get it in this course in any university in this country. That will assure you. You won't get partitions form course in any university in this country. It is not there. That is it. It has been designed specifically to do that. And I'm doing it with experience from the US, the UK, the Netherlands, etc. That is what they're doing. They are doing it. You meet different, either some of the students who are they are in France now, taking a semester out of here. Some of them called me. I got two of my students, Judith and some of them, they called me. So, which class going to, how do we do our partitions form? What they are doing, music and that sort of, and things like that. And those things, they are doing something that are, and I say, yes. That's when we tell you that these things are unique. It is unique to the system that you have. We have, because our needs are different from what they also, yes, look at it. They are looking at other social skills for you to be able to mingle, network, and those things like that. And these are some of the things that you have to do. Okay, then. Good. Thank you very much.